This is Dumb Down Life, number 49.
Every day. Christmas.
Is it Christmas?
Is it?
I don't know. I guess it must
possibly
be.
Possibly.
That's got to be the cheesiest song I've ever heard.
Well, all I can say is that you clearly weren't around at the birth of podcasting, because that was one of the first like big collaborations between all the PodSafe music artists, and it was done for charity.
It sounds like a charity song, doesn't it?
But it wasn't one of these sort of everybody get together in a studio and do it. It was I'm trying to remember the name of the guy who arranged it, and it completely escapes me, but one guy arranged it and sent out a bass track for everybody to then record to. He then had everybody mail the stuff back to him and mixed it all together so it sounded like everybody was in the studio.
Oh wow, that's pretty cool actually.
Yeah,
I'll take it back.
It might be cheesy, but it's Christmas cheese.
Yes, Christmas cheese. That's it was the group go under the name of PodSafe for Peace.
One hit wonder.
Yeah.
Some may even question whether it was a hit.
It, yeah. And the song was, if you didn't guess, it was called If Every Day Were Christmas.
And now, be prepared to hear that again.
Yes.
Because we don't get to break that one out very often.
No, I'm sure we'll play it again and again and again. We've got a whole month. So actually, this brings me on to what I wanted to talk about today. It's the... Well, what day is it today? It's the 2nd of December?
It is indeed.
Right. Isn't it a bit early for Christmas?
Not on the 2nd of December, no.
You don't think?
Nope.
Now, I wandered around my local town. When would it have been? Thursday last week. So we were still in November. And there were people with Christmas trees and lights and stuff in their house already.
Yeah, well, there was something in the summer. There was some town that had started to put their Christmas lights up in the summer, because in the winter, all of their road maintenance people are out gritting the roads and fixing the roads, and so it seemed a wrong time to be using resources to put up Christmas decorations.
Sure. So they put the lights up, but they don't turn them on, right?
Which, okay, yeah, but they're up for a good 3 or 4 months before they turn them on.
Yeah, I mean, I can understand that from a logistics point of view, but I don't know, I just kind of feel the sort of Christmas time frame is growing. I really don't think you want to put your decorations up until about 2 weeks before Christmas, personally.
Now, first week of December, December the 1st, is the first day of Advent, and it traditionally, at least in our house, it used to be that the Advent calendars went up on December the 1st, and then any time between then and December the 25th, the decorations would go up.
Yeah.
Not been unknown for them to go up on the 23rd.
Now, when you say in our house, is that when you were a kid or in your house?
Both, really. When I was a kid, the advent calendars went up on the 1st of December. When I had kids, the advent calendars went up on the 1st of December, and all the chocolate had gone by the 3rd of December. Mysteriously, Santa and his little elves would come early and nick all the chocolate.
Chocolates. There you go. You can't get the staff, can you? But, no, I don't know. I kind of feel 2 weeks before Christmas is good, because, frankly, I'd be sick of it by the time Christmas Day came along. If the decorations had been up all month, then it just wouldn't feel special to me. The 2 weeks. You know, it's sort of a focused period of time, as opposed to just stretching out over the whole month.
Well, the thing is that the month is going to go pretty quick, because have you got a Christmas party to go for at work?
Yeah, the day before Christmas Eve.
Oh, blimey, okay.
We don't finish until the day before Christmas Eve, you see.
Well, yeah, but most companies don't finish until the day before Christmas Eve, but they also have their Christmas party in the weeks leading up to it.
No, we have ours on the last day of work. We work half a day. And then we'll go out for a meal.
Right.
And then end up down at the bowling alley for a few games of bowls. And then the older people will generally wander off home, and the younger lot will wander off getting drunk. Yeah.
Well, the we had the departmental Christmas party is on Thursday, which is why I'm not going to be doing the show this week. And then the following week is like the company Christmas party, which is a penguin suit jobby at Pinewood Studios. And so, you know, and that's 2 weeks, and then there's a spare week, and then it's Christmas. The month has sort of gone. Nice. And I wouldn't have thought that going to Christmas parties while there's no sort of sign of it being Christmas. I think December 1st is when you start celebrating. Much earlier than that, don't need to. And yeah, it gets a bit tiresome. But once you hit December the 1st, this month is just going to fly.
So you reckon once you hit December, anything goes then, really?
Yeah, well, apart from opening presents, I mean, that has to wait until the 25th. But yeah, it you can crack open your Christmas compilation albums and
I've got to
expect to hear all the dross on the radio. Yeah, it's fine.
I've already heard Kirsty MacColl and the Pogues, The Fairy Tale of New York. Still, by far the best Christmas song ever, in my opinion. I've heard Slade.
Mary Slade Christmas is the one.
I've heard that one. I've heard Wizard, I Wish It Could Be Christmas. And I've heard Wham's Last Christmas as well. So musically, yes, it is definitely Christmas already.
Well, Slade was what was used to wake us up on Christmas morning.
Was it?
the hi-fi, which is downstairs, would be whacked all the way open. And
you needed waking up on
Christmas! Time to get up then.
You needed waking up on Christmas Day.
We were good little boys.
No. When I was young, I was up... Oh Christ, I was awake at like 5. Can we get up and open the presents yet? No, go back to sleep.
6, and don't marry the one who loves you, don't marry the one you love, marry the one who loves you. What do you do if they're both the same person?
Well, then you're just kind of lucky, I guess.
Am I lucky?
You must be. Right. Having just spoken about Christmas, I'm on a sort of a bit of a whinge tip this week, I think. It must be my health. Because for the observant of you will notice that I've got an absolutely stinking cold and a bit of a sore throat. But having not been able to do one last week, I thought I'd better make the effort this week.
Yeah.
So, Batman is dead.
Didn't he die before?
No.
What about this broken back business?
He never died. He had his back.
Oh, did he
broken.
Not?
No. The story before, that was about 10 years ago, probably.
Oh,
even
really?
More.
So I'm up to date.
Yeah, no, God, flipping heck. It must have been about 10 years ago. They ran a story arc called Nightfall. And this is where the villain Bane came from. He was absolutely mauled in the Batman films when he came out. But yeah, I've spoken about that before. Let's not go down that route. Bane basically broke Bruce Wayne's back. And somebody else had to step into the role of Batman. But he turned out to be a bit of an arse and quite nasty. Bruce Wayne gets all fixed up, patched up, and then comes back and beats the crap out of the guy that is Batman and becomes Batman again. But this time round, he's actually dead. He was killed, shot. And I don't know whether he's going to come back as Batman. From the stories that I've read on the internet, the interviews with the guy that wrote the story. Let's see if I can open that. No, I can't. The guy that wrote the story has said that there is going to be somebody else playing Batman, and it's going to have some big repercussions, and it's going to last for a long, long time. So it would appear that they've decided to kill Bruce Wayne off.
But you've simply read this as a reported. You've not read the. What is it?
It is a comic.
A comic. It is a comic. It's not.
Comic, yes.
Okay, but you've not read the comic yet.
No,
is the
I
comic
haven't.
Out yet?
Yes, it is. It came out on the 26th, but I don't know whether it's out in the UK.
Right.
It's definitely out. DC Comics out in the US, but I don't know how up to date the UK is with what's going on in the US as far as comics go. Do we get them at the same
imported,
time, or do we have to import it? I don't know. So I'm assuming this is the US current storyline. I do actually know how he dies, but I don't know whether I should say, in case anybody doesn't want to know.
I leave it as it is for the moment. I think Batman Dies is a big enough big enough headline. So the who controls the canon as to what the story is?
Detective Comics, DC.
But there's not one particular person that owns the canon. You know, if the only thing that I can compare with it, if we talk about Star Wars, we know that George Lucas calls
right.
the shots. Is there somebody that owns the Batman?
No, DC own it. As far as I'm aware, anyway, Bob Kane created Batman, but he was working for DC at the time.
Right.
It's the same as probably a more famous comic writer, comic creator is Stan Lee.
Yep.
He doesn't own the rights to
any of his
because he was an employee of Marvel Comics, so they
right.
own the copyright.
As opposed to Lucas, who wrote the game, wrote the film, made the company and directed it and wrote
and
the T-shirt and
you know,
merchandising.
Yeah, I mean, he owns everything and what he says goes sort of thing, but that's not the case in the comic world. So DC basically get to do whatever the hell they want. I just think killing the guy behind the mask is a really bad move. If you were going to end the comic and say, well, that's it, Batman's been running since the 1940s, he's sort of, we've done all we can with him, let's finish it, then fine. Obviously that's not the case with the new movies coming out. Batman's going to go on for a long, long time.
Yeah.
But to decide to change who Batman is, I mean, it wouldn't just necessarily be Batman, we could have any sort of costume hero, but in this case it is Batman, but to kill off who the guy behind the mask is just doesn't work for me, because the whole point of the story, especially for somebody like Batman, it's the story of Bruce Wayne, it's the story of how he became Batman. His parents were murdered and this is the way he dealt with it. It was as much of a revenge thing as it is any sort of high-minded morals. You take away that side of Batman, you take away the Bruce Wayne part, what is it? It's just a guy behind a mask.
Yeah.
You've not got that story anymore.
So, do you know who it is that's going to be behind the mask?
Yeah, no. The big money is on either the current Robin or the original Robin, who is now Nightwing, I think.
Right.
That's sort of what the big money is, that one of those will step in and carry it on.
Yeah.
But I don't know, there's something about it, I just don't like the idea at all.
I remember, I don't follow it close enough to know where all these different bits slot in, but on the Cartoon Network there was a Batman that seemed to be a young man who Bruce Wayne was the mentor to. Was that this whole Dark Knight series?
No, this is that's Batman Beyond.
And is that something completely different story arc altogether?
It's kind of set in the same universe, but sort of 50 years in the future, where Bruce Wayne is too old to carry on, and he does hand it on to somebody else then.
But he's not dead.
But he's not dead, no. So if that's canon, you can only assume that somehow Bruce Wayne is going to be resurrected.
Yeah.
Or if that's not canon, it's a different universe, it's not part of the same DC world as the comics, then you can just plain ignore it.
They've done that a lot with Batman, haven't they? They sort of have different approaches and remakes of the film and the remake of the, well, not remake of the film, but
I think they reinvent him every so often to sort of bring him up to date.
So rather than him being brought back to life in this medium, as it were, perhaps he'll simply be brought back to life in a different film,
or are they just going to reboot the whole story and start again?
Yeah.
Just sort of kill it completely, that's that, finished, we'll start again and do a new origin story but make it more modern. I don't know.
Yeah.
I kind of hope they do, if that's sort of where it's going. I don't like the idea of continuing on as Batman with somebody else in the title role, so to speak.
It would be interesting to see, because how would that character sort of get back to that? They would have to have the resources that Bruce had, so would he have left them in his will? And
I think this is possibly one of the reasons why it's suspected that one of the two Robins
would do it, yeah.
Because they were both sort of wards of Bruce Wayne, so that it would be quite easy for him to have left the Wayne estate to them.
And is the butler still around, or has he
changed?
I have
no idea.
You don't know?
I don't read the comics. I don't read the comics at all. It was just a news story I picked up, and I thought, whoa, wait a minute, hang on, what are they doing?
Yeah. One of the things that I did see recently that I liked the look of, was it DC versus Mortal Kombat or something?
Yes.
Seen that one?
Yes, I have.
That looks interesting, because I was working at Virgin Interactive when Mortal Kombat 2 was released, and it was one of the games that we supported. Mm-hmm. So yeah, seeing the DC characters playing against the Mortal Kombat characters, that'd be fantastic.
Yeah, kind of one-sided, I think, with Superman, surely.
No, the stuff that Raiden and all that can do, no, not at all.
See, I don't know Mortal Kombat at all.
It's not all martial arts. It's like lightning bolts and freeze balls and all sorts of different special moves and things.
Right.
So, it's just as much powerful as a superhero would have. So yeah, it'd be quite fun.
But there is one I did see. I think is it Soul Calibur?
The Star Wars one.
Yeah. Where you play Vader and Yoda and stuff, don't you?
Yeah, but what I didn't like about that is I think the Xbox, which is the 360, is the white box, therefore it's the light side, therefore with that one you can play Yoda and the good guys. With the PS3 being the black box, it's Darth Vader and all the dark side characters.
Are you joking?
So you have to have one platform or the other to play one set of characters or the other. You can't play both on both.
Yeah, that sucks.
Yeah. That's just pandering to the manufacturers of the hardware, isn't it?
Yeah. Yeah. Especially,
you know, that Star Wars geeks like you and I go, well, we've got to have both.
Plus the fact is I borrowed Ben's Xbox Elite and that's black.
Oh, right.
Go figure.
You're listening to Dumbed Down Life. You're listening to Dumbed Down Life.
Hi, this is Ken again with another useless bit of information about the human voice. This is Tim Storms. He holds the Guinness record for the greatest range for the male voice, and also for the lowest note produced by a human. Weird as it may sound, this note is below the range of the human hearing ability. He has a range of 6 octaves. A full 2 octaves off to the left of the piano keyboard. And this is the only recording I could find of him, thanks to YouTube.
That last bit, was that him singing?
Yeah.
Wow.
Whales all over the place again. we've got another one of those for a future show. Again, that's from Ken from Derby. It's great. Some of these things that, like, you and I might spend an evening going around YouTube, going from relevant clip to relevant clip and finding out odd bits of data, and either it sticks in your brain or, you know, you just absorb it and go on to something else. But for Dad, Ken from Derby, to make these little clips that share the knowledge, I think that's really good.
Yeah, I do like what he's doing, actually. Has he got some more to come?
I say there's one more to come, and he tends to mail them in when he's found something interesting, so quite how many more, we'll have to find out.
Feel today, feel today. okay, be okay, be okay. I just wanna be okay today. I just wanna be okay, be okay, be okay. I just wanna be okay today. I just wanna feel the day, feel the day, feel the day. I just wanna feel something new. I just wanna feel something.
Michaelson and Be OK, and you may recognise the voice as being the girl who did the iPod adverts.
I know I knew her from somewhere. Didn't we play that song a little, not that song, but the iPod song a little while ago?
We played the iPod song a little while back, yep, and this particular song I heard played on This Week in London, and so I thought, yes, that one's fantastic. Apparently Ingrid's actually got a new album coming out.
Okay.
So we shall find some links and send you off to buy that for somebody for Christmas, because that's a cracking track, that one.
It is, I like that.
Oh, there goes the race track again.
Sorry.
Obligatory, yeah, the race track, the dog barking. I've not had that yet.
Give it time.
The advent calendar. Have you had a chance to have a look at the advent calendar yet?
I've been clicking it every day religiously. Well,
clicking it
the last 2 days anyway.
At the beginning of November, I thought, well, this would be a great idea. We can make up this advent calendar, and we've got a month. Lance can do some artwork for it, and we can make a calendar out of it, and I'll do some programming. And it got to this weekend, I thought, oh!
In my defense, I did spend 2 weeks in America.
Yeah, and you've been back 2 weeks since.
Yeah, but in my defense, I did spend 2 weeks in America.
But yeah, I think the pair of us spent one evening trying to get some decent 3D rendering of the logo to make. It wouldn't work at all, would it?
No. Oh, God, I was going to work on that for you. I forgot all about it.
But I'm trying to get that heart shape in 3D.
Do you know, the triangles and the lettering is a piece of piss. It's no problem whatsoever. It's that bloody heart.
Yeah.
Who was it who came up with this design?
Well, see, even though with the triangles, having the D's in the middle, cutting those out nicely is going to be a bit difficult.
No, I can do that very easily. It's just getting the shape of that damned heart.
Oh, weird. Okay. But what I've done now is I've been collecting together various websites, YouTube clips, and where possible free software like games and things like that. The first link that I put up was a link to Straight No Chaser, which is an a cappella group. Go to the website dumbdownlife.com/advent1.htm, click on box number one, then it comes up with a little picture, click on that little picture, and it then takes you to the YouTube clip. Straight No Chaser were an a cappella group that were, I guess they sung for a university back in 1996. And last year, one of the group put up some of the video from 1996 on YouTube, just to sort of show the other guys that were in the group, really. Nothing special. But within a couple of months, they got 8 million views.
Wow.
And with the 8 million views also came a record contract from EMI, so it shows that YouTube can be used to promote artists and so forth without needing to put big money behind them. They've now actually got an album out of Christmas songs that was released this year, so best of luck to them, and I hope they make a lot from that.
That's fantastic.
Today being the 2nd, most people won't be listening to this on the 2nd, but for the 2nd of December, I actually put a link up to a program, a game called, what's it called?
Continuum.
Continuum. I knew there was some something yum. a game called Continuum, which is a free game. You can download it and install it. Windows only, unfortunately. Sorry, Dave. actually, I've not tried running it under Wine. Going too geeky, sorry.
What's Wine? This
is Wine is a program that lets you run Windows programs under Linux.
An emulator sort of thing, is it?
Sort of thing, yeah. And Dave being very Linuxy, I'll have to find something for him. before Continuum was what it was called Subspace. And it was a game that was released by Virgin Interactive, which is the company that I worked for, about 12 years ago now. So I knew the game. It's now free. Go out there and play it. It's very similar in controls to like Asteroids, the old Asteroids game, where you spin your spaceship left and right, only instead of shooting at asteroids, you're shooting at hundreds of other players that are all linked up on the same game across the world. So
it's a massive multiplayer online
game.
Asteroids game.
Yeah, absolutely. And it's free, and it will suck up hours and hours of time. So because the game was designed such a long time ago, it really doesn't require much of your computer. So even if your computer is pretty old, it'll still play it pretty well. And as for what's coming up on the 3rd, the 4th, the 5th, you'll have to go to the page and find out. If you can't remember the URL or you have trouble typing in the URL, just to go to the home page for Dumb Down Life and click on where it says Christmas, and that will take you to the advent calendar. draft and woke up dead, which is a kind of strange title.
Did you hear the whole of the chorus?
I didn't, because I had to make a quick dash to the little boy's room.
It woke up dead about 4 a.m. just in time to see the setting sun. If you remember what I said that day, be sure to write it down and send it on my way.
Yeah.
It's one of the songs that I've been listening to an awful lot the last 2 or 3 weeks at work. I think it's a fantastic track.
Yeah, I don't know why, but I got the feeling of somebody woke up to find out they died in their sleep.
I think it's just a song of just complete contradictions more than anything.
Yeah. We have some feedback.
No, really?
Yeah, we do. We really do. For those of you who remember, so long ago when we did the last show, although actually it wasn't that long ago, is it? We've not missed any. It's just been a little bit longer between the recording. We did a special Leonie birthday show, and so Leonie has written to us, "Hi fellas," which I thought was unusual, because I'd have thought she'd have said, "Hey ho, Leonie here," like she does with a voicemail. "Hi fellas, just a quick note." Sorry. Yep, there we go.
There's the dog. Hey.
The podcast is nearly over. Shush. Thank you. "Hi fellas, just a quick note to thank everyone." And right, okay, hang on. Door has got to be shut because she's not going to be quiet.
She must know. She must think, right, you've been going on long enough now. Wrap it up, lads.
Exactly, that's it. Right, but we can't interrupt Leonie's feedback. She's taken the time and the trouble to write to us.
Absolutely.
And we're always complaining about not getting feedback. So here we go. "Hi, fellas. Just a quick note to thank everyone for singing happy birthday to me on last week's show. It helped make my birthday very special. I left a blank there because I'm not going to reveal the lady's age." Ah. I mean, that's just rude. "Leonie, regular con respondent to the Bugcast. But you plug in somebody else's podcast on ours."
Did you give it?
"Leonie, regular correspondent to the Bugcast, West Suffolk." I thought the Bugcast was up north. Oh, I don't know.
No.
So yeah, that was, who was it that sung that? God, it seemed like ages ago now, but yeah, thank you to everybody who helped with that recording.
It was you, me, Doug, Bobby, and Dave, I think.
Dave, that's it, yeah. I am attempting to do something very similar with a more seasonal feel to it. So those of you who talk and correspond with the show frequently, expect to see something in the email very soon.
Oh, good God. I've got a sore throat. I can't do anything.
Yeah, right. Could add to the comedy effect.
Yeah, or ruin it completely.
or ruin it completely, yeah. So, we may well be doing a show on Thursday. Well, I say we, I mean, there may well be a show recording on Thursday.
There will be, but one way or another.
One way or another, there will be a show recorded. We try and get one done once a week, and it might overflow from one week to the next, but especially now coming up to the annual, coming up to the 1 year anniversary, we want to try and get all 52 shows in before the 20th of December.
I think,
because that was the first one was recorded.
Yeah, now we've got some sort of plans to do a best of for that show, haven't we?
Certainly clips from other shows. If the whole show itself isn't made up of best ofs, we will certainly be doing some clips. And if anybody who's listened to all 50 odd of the shows has a particular best of bit that they'd like to hear again, then please let us know. And we've also got some recorded stuff that ended up on the virtual cutting floor, as it were. So some material from the shows that has never been heard.
Never been heard before.
Can I go now? some material that's never been heard before.
You can call the Dumbed Down Life crew on 07-092-274-759.
You can follow us on Twitter. Our account name is Dumbed Down Life.
The email address is ddl.podshow@gmail.com. The website address is www.dumbeddownlife.com.
Now, normally there is a little bit that goes at the end of that, but I just haven't had time to do it today because I only really just got this whole thing working today.
But we had to record something afterwards because people are coming to expect there to be something at the end. You know, I've made it, you know.
There will be for next week, but...
And if there wasn't anything after that, then next week, as soon as it starts, they go, oh, okay, we know the rest of it, just turn it off.
Oh, yes. I'm sorry.
Wouldn't appreciate it. So.
Sue me. Look, I've just got my computer working. It's a damn sight healthier than it used to be, and I am. haven't had the time to do it, but there will be one for next week.
And meanwhile, don't forget, the Bugcast will be recording on Friday, and we will, or Dumbed Down Life will be recording on Thursday, and the Random 3 will be recording... Oh, will it? No, because Mark was just saying he's off to Brazil, isn't he?
I think he's doing one this week, but he's off to Brazil after that.
After that. All right. Till then.
Ta-ra.
Ta-ra.